Hey, there you are. You interested in getting checked out for the RV-6? I need a ride to my brother's place. I figured I could show you how to fly the RV-6 on the way there, and if you don't kill us, you can fly it back. Let me show you this beauty. These RVs are something. They're fast, fuel-efficient, aerobatic, not to mention pretty. The RV-6 is a completely different animal from the Icon A5. The RV-6 isn't hard to fly, but it is fast, so you'll need to keep your head out in front. Believe it or not, I built this baby myself. Don't let the idea of a kit or a home-built aircraft scare you, though. The RV is the best-selling kit in the world with over 7,000 flying. Well, let's get a move on. Hop on in. I'll get her started. Checklist is pretty simple. Throttle open, 1/8 of an inch. Prop high RPM. Master switch, on. Flaps, up. Fuel pump, on. Mixture is full rich. Clear prop! Oil pressure, good. She purrs like a kitten, doesn't she? Alternator, on. Radios, on. Lights, on.
Okay, you have the flight controls. Taxi over to runway 03. Give it a little throttle and let's go. Let's stop here. Let me perform the before takeoff checklist. Canopy closed, fuel pump on, flight instruments set. Mixture is full rich. Elevator trim set. Oil pressure and engine temps good. Runway looks clear. Let's go. With the runway and push that throttle to full. Lift the nose at 55 knots and hold it there until she flies. Climb out to 1,000 feet at 110 knots, then you can get a feel for the aircraft. Yeah, she climbs out nice, doesn't she? Good power to weight ratio. Continue climbing to 1,000 feet and then level up. Turn to a heading of 340 and let's head out over Hilo Bay. Go ahead and fly north along the coast. Want to show you a really cool spot I found. The RV is quite a performer compared to what you've flown so far. Flies faster, turns harder, it'll even fly upside down. While we fly along the coast, go ahead and see what the plane can do. If you're up for it, try pulling some high G turns, aerobatics, or maybe a stall. Aerobatics are no problem for this aircraft. Just be sure to stay under 6 G's. Now that's a high G turn. Check the G meter to see what we pulled. Nice roll. That's a quick way to get a feel for the aircraft. Always interesting seeing the world upside down. Hey, nice loop. We're in a stall. Let the nose drop and add full throttle. Nice recovery. Flying low along the cliffs, it's a blast. We're a little fast. Max speed is 183 knots. Times. Woo-hoo! All left deck. Good. Now to the right. To the left. Straight for a little while. Gentle turn to the right. The stream splits ahead. Take the left route. It gets too narrow beyond this point. Go ahead and pull up. Nice, fine. That'll get your blood moving. Let's head toward my brother's place and I'll walk you through a landing. He lives near a private strip called Honoka. Let's go ahead and have fun with the plane. Just get me there alive, okay? We're getting close. To line up with the Honokaa airstrip, you're gonna want to fly to the northern tip of the town. These RVs are slick airplanes, so you have to think about slowing down early. You want to be going 75 knots for the approach, so start gradually slowing down now. Pull the power to 10% or 1200 RPM and let some speed bleed off. And we're over the town. The runway is at a heading of 265. This runway is small, hard to see. You got yourself a challenging landing today. Let's lower the flaps. Flaps help us slow down for landing. Hold the flap switch until they're all the way down. This is a good approach speed. Keep your airspeed above 65 knots. When we cross the threshold, pull the power to idle. We're looking to touch the main gear first at around 55 knots. Now hold the nose up and let the rest of our speed bleed off. Touchdown. Hold the elevator back to keep weight off the nose wheel. This runway is in bad shape. Okay, taxi over to the hangars and I'll hop out. Stop here. I'm gonna trust you to get the plane back to Hilo in one piece. Think you can handle that? Oh, and remember to keep some up elevator in as you taxi and take off again so you don't damage the nose gear. Thanks for the ride. ¶¶